Hey, folks. Thank you guys for tuning in to our Friday night D&D game. We're here every other week with Barkey's Brigade. I'm your host tonight, GM Mace. Let's go around the table. Let's introduce everybody. And we also have some business we'll get to. But let's introduce everyone. Let's start over here.
I'm Amy Vorpal. I'm playing Arky Barkey.
Who is a what?
Who is a human barbarian. Claire.
I'm Virva Arian, and I'm playing Atuska Nakeen, who is a high elf rogue.
I'm Sean Graham, and I'm playing Donovan Belter, who is a half-elf paladin.
Hey, everybody. I'm Tom Lommel. I am playing Udo Meinhardt, who is a half-elf sorcerer.
And I'm Chris Greenwood. I am playing Asher Flint, who is a half-elf bard.
Nice. I'm excited to kill you all. If you guys haven't seen, we're running a poll on our Facebook page. Go to facebook.com/savingthrowshow. We need to figure out what we're going to do for season two of Saving Throw. Season one, we taught Pathfinder. Season two, we could teach Cthulhu? Maybe?
So we're going to teach people the madness of Cthulhu? Holy shit, this is amazing. I get cultists.
You can recruit and make your own cultists. And we'll teach you, walk through all of it.
Cthulhu has to win, though.
Yeah. You have to go. You have to vote. Vote for Cthulhu. Because Mason said so. But vote for whatever the fuck you want.
Now, if you want a game that's going to end in misery, despair, and destruction, and inevitable insanity, pick GURPS. Or... pick Cthulhu. It's just a nonstop march toward the brink of madness, and then, bloom.
You just do a little better each time. Yeah.
No, you do a little bit crazier every time, and then it's just time to pull the pin on that grenade and wipe everybody out.
Yeah.
I'm going to make a new character who is a brother of this one who's been getting constant notes.
I tried that in Dungeons & Dragons, and you got mad.
You and Barky, you both tried to bring new characters in. Shame on you both. Next, as we're going into the second season of this second session of this campaign of Barky's Brigade, it's officially a campaign. Sean. Mm-hmm. Just want to note that.
I ain't no chump.
But we have a sweet, sweet figurine provided to us by Iron Tusk Miniatures. Go to facebook.com/IronTuskMiniaturePainting. Sean, is this your character? I hope you're not attached to him. Can we put this back down here so you can see it? Can we see it in the camera? Or should we put it under the dice cam?
Oh, the dice cam. That can make sense, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so they can see to the top of it. Oh, there we go. Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah. There we go. That's horizontal. That's good.
Yes, so that's Iron Tusk Miniature. They painted that for us. Each week we're going to be showing off different characters from this party. You're going to see them, but you're not going to get a close-up look.
Get a look at that backside.
Is my hand blocking? I can't.
Okay.
He's a smartly dressed.
The detail is amazing.
The detail is really good.
Donovan Belter.
Yeah, Paladin. He painted the backside because we'll probably see a lot of that as Donovan runs away.
Yeah. Oh no, Donovan, here's the thing about Donovan, he is stubborn in his pursuit of his goal, and he will probably die.
It's okay.
We have a superstition that because he's been featured tonight, this is it. This is his last session for Donovan.
Yeah, I'm actually Donovan's going to be killed because of this.
He looks like a nice man.
Mm. He'll make a nice corpse. next up.
Fondly.
Sorry, excuse me. Next up, as you know, you can be part of the game here. If you donate to us, you think the fight's going too easy, go ahead and donate. I'll throw in some more baddies. Mess these guys up. You think it's going too hard? Maybe we'll get some guys to help them out. Yeah. All the details are listed below in the, not in the chat, but in the description. Let's go read through that. Find something you like.
My character got an inspiration point, and the fight ended before I got it, so now Arky Barky gets the inspiration point.
Yes, yay! And that was donated to our first person, Live to Game.
Live to Game.
Greatest person in the history of the world.
Yes, you too can be great like Live to Game if you give us money.
The next person to donate will be the second greatest person in the history of the world.
it's diminishing returns, people, so get your pledges in now.
Yeah.
Now, also... because you have an inspiration point, we've got campaign tokens that we're going to be using for the inspiration points. Tom, can you tell us a little bit about the campaign tokens?
We're gonna go
down in here. So that's what the treasure's for. These are the campaign coins trade bars.
Coins, sorry.
So these are this is fantasy currency. As you can hear, it is very hefty. The sculpts are very detailed. Amy, pick one that you want to use for your inspiration token. They have a Kickstarter going on right now, which is the reason that I have this stuff. They sent me a little preview of all of their coins. And they have a great deal on, you know, like if you want to put a different pack together. So if you want to put a pack of like, you know, low level gold pieces that are just things you'd use for kind of buying drinks at the pub, or if you want to do a big fat loot dragon's hoard, you can do that. And they're super fun.
Oh, yeah, awesome.
And there's something about just like having these, like I said, the great thing about these is you can use them like, oh, you've got inspiration, terrific. You get this.
And you can use them as actual U.S. currency.
Yeah, that's not legal. But,
that's not true.
And but they also make great slammers, because we're going to bring Pogs back.
Yes.
I'm going to pick the dragon one. Okay. I love dragons. If I could date a dragon, I would date
And actually,
dragon.
This...
Dragons can take
where
you
is
form.
It? Like that's the 100.
Oh, show him to me, baby.
That is the 1,000. I'm looking for the 5,000. This has
ridiculous.
Never been before been seen in real life.
What?
This is the 5,000 trade bar. This is a Kickstarter bonus that they haven't made many of yet that they're going to put in their new production run. So if you go to campaigncoins.com
those
or just search Kickstarter for campaign coins,
you
can
buy. Kickstarter
them? Yeah, you can buy. It's going till May 7th, and you can buy little 10 packs. They're based in Australia. They're super nice guys, and it's just really like, I don't know. I've seen a lot of different props and stuff for your game table, and this is just so much fun to kind of like, it's a neat piece of nerd swag to have and to hand out in your
I'll
game.
I'll tell you, they're getting to $40 from me. That's happening. As soon as I get out of here.
They're so beautiful. Live to game, we got a dragon on our side.
Bam.
Very good.
Let's hope it doesn't get her
You're
killed.
You're stupid if you think those aren't awesome.
Actually, can we leave those in there?
Yes,
cool.
We can.
Like,
you
want to
leave
dice.
Those in the dice tray? Absolutely. Yes.
I think that looks cool.
Awesome.
Awesome.
I like the sound of them.
Yeah.
They're like,
yeah. That's why I want to go. I want to use them as real currency. Like I want to go.
What was that one?
I'll take
that
one Pepsi, please.
Yeah, and just throw these.
Dragon?
That's the. I think that's the 1,000.
I feel like if I went into a store and just went like that onto the counter and bought a Pepsi, they'd be like, you know what, that was pretty cool. So here's your Pepsi.
Good enough.
Yeah.
Enjoy.
This is a land.
So last but not least, as we've been touting all day through our Twitter feed, Facebook, what have you, we're giving away a fantasy-themed loot crate during the show today. Oh. We're going to have more details on how you can win it during the break, so stay tuned, keep watching, and if you're a smart, clever individual, you will go ahead and get a one-month subscription to loot crates. So we'll figure that all out in about an hour, hour and a half. It'll be good stuff. So, who remembers where we last left off in this game?
I was getting us out of that troll cavern.
We got 144 XP. That's where we left off.
That's right. You also got 144 XP. You guys had met up with your friend Swadohas in the town of Perlamore. He had said that he has a need for adventurers. You guys all answer the call. You guys have all had experiences with him at one time or another. And you all are learning to work together as you've brutally murdered a small pack of kobolds just sitting around a fire. I mean, they weren't even attacking. They were just there.
But they were going through Sadohas's bag.
That's true. You did find
and
his
they
bag.
Were kobolds.
Yeah. Also true. You guys put your rogue in the front to do a little investigation. She found a gelatinous cube.
Good
That's
job.
Pretty good.
Sure did.
Well,
with her
the
face.
Way she found it,
but
yeah.
She found
yeah.
it.
She found it with
really
her face.
Issue.
Finding it, totally fine.
There was a lot of finding in it, and then getting away from it, and then finding it found us several times.
Yeah, at no point did we just decide, hey, this thing's slower than us, let's run. It was
let's
like
go home.
We kept fighting it.
Yeah.
You know, if it were just sitting around a campfire, I might have just left it alone.
We know for a fact that's not true.
Okay.
On there, you guys found Swadohas in the next room in an ogre's lair, look like. You guys got him, you guys got him healed up, and you guys heard the ogre coming back to his home. So you guys ran as fast as you could. We found a crack in the side wall. Thank you, Mr.
To the bard. Thanks
to the bard.
Asher.
Asher, that's the character's name. I was like, what is his name? Asher.
It is a campaign, but it's a new campaign.
You know it's a campaign because the DM can't remember who's who.
Yeah.
Even though all of the names are right in front of him. Okay. Yes. Professional Dungeon Master, GM Mace.
I don't have any excuse for this. You're absolutely right. Sepuko. So, you guys found a crack. You guys went down the crack. You guys got Swadohas with you. You guys are rolling around the crack. What's wrong?
Did you just giggle about you went down the crack?
Yes, we both did, and so did Sean. Raise your hand if you didn't giggle.
Okay, well, the mature ones are over here.
No.
Hi, thank you. Don't cry. It's
gonna
be okay.
She's dying already.
Down the crack.
I have things that'll kill you. Don't die yet. I'm going to sit here. I want to just stay on yeah. Vierva here.
So good. So good. Ready.
Okay.
All right. Everyone good?
Yeah. Yes.
Great?
Yes.
Okay. Let's take this guy off because he no longer needs to be up there. Man, that's heavy. Mm-hmm. I'm scared to put him up there.
That's another Iron Tusk.
Another Iron Tusk awesomeness. Got showed off last week. I don't know if I can fit that.
He looks great right
just,
there.
Yeah, yeah. Let's do that.
Okay. I like it.
I've had to cover up my dungeon or else the players will see it and then, you know.
He said not to peek. It was hard.
So hard to not peek at my dungeon.
Wait.
There's oh. There's the dungeon.
Oh, no.
Here.
Yeah, I looked directly at it for a while.
Studied not, it, if yeah, you will.
I did not. I did not.
I made sketches.
You know, yeah. It is your last game, so.
Yeah, no, I was like, oh, well, he would have definitely covered it up if he didn't want me looking at it. So then I looked at it for a while.
Stared.
Not my fault.
No, it's not. You're absolutely right. It is mine. I should have blinded everyone before this game started.
How is someone who looks so honest and buttoned up, like, so clearly, like, cheating?
He's a deviant.
I'm not.
He hides in plain sight.
Oh, I am a real deviant.
Yeah, he is.
Here's the thing, guys. When it comes right down to it, I don't tie my shoes sometimes.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Whoa.
But also, the choking game.
You mean neck throw.
Neck throw.
Neck throw.
Neck throw.
Neck throw.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Prior to the cameras rolling, Amy reminded us that Sean used to play a childhood game where they would literally strangle each other until they passed out.
It sounds really bad when you say it that
apparently
way.
Apparently you get a high from it, but I couldn't remember the name, and I called it neck throat.
Neck throat.
Neck throat.
Okay, so we got out of a thing.
So we get out of the cave.
We get out of the crack.
Right, you guys were working your way through the cave. Did you guys light any torches? Have any light source of any kind while you're working?
I'm a half elf. I'm not.
Half elves have dim light vision.
That's great. Or there is no light. Oh, dark vision.
The dark vision.
Well, I'll just shut up.
No, I didn't.
I thought somebody had. Didn't nobody has nothing?
Well, don't you have a torch?
Yeah. You can. I'm just wondering, did anyone light one?
No, we never
I'm not
lit
you
a light.
Can't.
Never lit a lit.
I'm saying, do you guys want to light one?
Starting this.
Sounds like we should.
Should you?
I don't know. We all have dark vision.
Oh, from the ogre following us.
She's human.
Yeah, Arky Barky doesn't.
But I'm just following.
Yeah,
we'll
just put
thing.
Two in front, two behind her, and she just.
Yeah.
No.
You'd be like the daredevil, you know? You just figure it out.
I don't. I feel like that's a bad.
So no light.
No, yeah, we should light a light. Let's light a light.
All right,
yeah,
I can
go blind
press digitation to light any torch that we have. Any unlit
strong
torch.
If only someone had like a light spell. Ugh, it's so useful.
I can use press digitation to light something on fire, like a torch or you know something handheld.
No one has light, really? Oh, I thought the paladin
no.
would have had it. Well, all right. So who's lighting a torch? Who's doing it?
Who's probably
you're
the
one
of
the weak guys. You
I
should
guess
carry.
I'll light a
That's
torch,
your problem.
But I did. Yeah. Oh, I have an explorer's pack, so I have a torch. Okay, yeah. I light a torch.
Light a torch. Torch is lit. Congrats.
Hey guys, I'm gonna light a torch.
While we're doing bookkeeping, what is our marching order here? Since we're
Are we in a crack?
You guys are in a crack. Let me get Swadohas as well. Real.
Oh, that's right. He's with us. Wait, is he unconscious? I can't remember.
He's conscious. You guys healed him up.
Lead the way.
And got him going.
All right. Just to be safe. Now I'm going to lead the way.
What the hell was that?
I will. Maybe.
How's this integration?
Oh, I kept looking for my
thief. Oh, yeah, the thief.
I'll leave. I'll leave.
Yes. Good job, thief. Oh, Arky's third.
Are we sure we want the thief in front? I'm just saying.
I mean, yes. She can search for
you
traps.
Yeah, my me behind you.
It doesn't matter.
With her face.
I don't really care.
Okay, and then here's Swadohas because I don't have a mini form yet.
Swadohas, put him in the bag.
That's right. Let's
wow.
I'll take up the room.
Wait, why does he have scissor hands?
Because it's the first mini I could find.
Oh, I see. Okay.
And if I come across a better one, I'll swap him out.
Okay.
Until then. So, you guys are traveling.
Scissor hands. Like, that's much easier.
Before we start, we just got a donation from Twitch user The Tiger.
The Tiger! Yes!
The Tiger! Second best friend in the world.
I know Tiger. We play Neverwinter together. He's great.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice.
Thanks,
that's
Tiger.
Awesome.
You in like the same guild?
Just what, like a general donation?
Actually, we're waiting to get 5 players consistently showing up every time we stream, and we're going to start a guild at that point.
Nice.
Because it's a little premature to do it with 2 guys. It's kind of weird.
It's not a campaign until you get 5 guys together.
Just saying.
Or the choke. God.
It's actually called neck throat.
You're not allowed to talk unless you're on mic.
You only need two people to play neck.
Yep.
Actually, if you're good at it, you can just.
Actually,
don't play neck throat by yourself, kids.
My experience is you really want to have three people just to be safe.
One. So is it just like a triangle, like a triforce?
No, one person to catch them if they're going to hit a rock or something.
Oh, why that's are you playing the carpet? Rocks? Oh.
I'm just saying, like I hit my head on a couch.
You know, we're
one
delving
time
too deep into this. Let's get back to the game.
Where are we going?
Wait, what was the donation?
How much was it?
We're $3.
For what?
Hey, that's awesome.
We're finding out right now.
Ah.
What, I hope he's asking to throw more stuff at you guys.
No.
Because I would gladly do that.
No,
it's
going to be to assist us.
Oh, no. Like, more graph paper might come our way? Look out.
Oh, no. Graph paper.
Oh, no. Not graph paper. Oh, that's a better picture by far.
Who's this? That's Virva?
That's a really good picture.
Yes.
Tom.
Yes.
That's my favorite.
No.
Oh, nice. Yes, a reroll.
Yeah. Nice.
Wait, I'm going to take a coin for that.
Take a coin for it.
Thank you, sir.
Ooh. Okay. Ooh. You're making me write stuff down now.
I get a free reroll.
Yeah, no, I just got to write down who's got what. Who's who's got who.
Wait, you know what? I'm taking this.
So it appears that
20
the,
on one side, one on the other. That's
the
me.
The crevice did not lead just outside.
No, it did not. It led deeper into the...
Oh, so we went down? The crevice goes down into the mountain?
Oh, we're descending?
Yes. Into the Camridge Mountain?
That's an appropriate,
was
an appropriate
that a name
token
drop
that you took, Tom.
Camridge.
Let's hope so.
Oh my God, it's heard, the I heard that in Camridge there are more people with...
That's ridiculous.
Nice with faces?
Oh, well, that's awesome. That's a one, isn't it?
I was going to say more people with PhDs than in any other place in the country.
Cambridge?
Yep, that's what I was thinking of.
Okay, I was like, Cambridge doesn't have very many PhDs.
The Camridge Mountains.
So.
Yeah, that.
Virva. As you're leading the group through the darkness, you reach out and you feel felt, cloth.
Oh my God, we're in an Etsy store.
Nice, I can actually smell the disappointment of parents.
Do you have dark vision?
Yes, I do. I'm a high elf.
Yeah, she's an elf.
And you see that it's clothes hanging up.
Like literally an Etsy store.
Like yeah, literally a closet.
Like, are we going through Narnia, kind of?
Yes.
We're in a closet!
Is it in a closet?
Oh my God.
That's the way I start my epic campaign, Sean. In a closet.
The ogres.
Listen, it's not for me to tell you how to live your life.
It does
everyone
give you
has
the chance,
their own journey.
It does give you the chance to come out later.
Yeah.
I think I'm fighting.
I think we're about to, actually.
At the point that you're comfortable with.
Third date.
Okay.
I hear that's a rule, third date.
I think, bloody hell, I did. I have a mirror on a stick. Stick it through.
Yes.
Oh my God.
I love that little mirror. What,
are you like,
it's like
the closet. The little mirror sticks out.
That's fantastic.
Are you like a Navy SEAL? What is that?
It says mirror on a stick.
It's her familiar, guys.
Okay.
Familiar?
It's a little version of her.
She talks to it. She's like, this thing what is knows me better than
it's
anyone.
It's weird. Every time I talk,
I don't
it
trust
talks
any. Mirror on a stick, you get me.
I like to imagine it's like a small
what
dentist
is it?
Mirror.
Mar on a stick. Oh, yes. Moss.
So you stick your mirror out, look left, look right, and you see it is literally that, a small closet, about 10, 15 feet wide by 10 across.
So we're facing the interior of a closet, or we're facing
as
into
in
the room?
As in there's clothes that she would pass through into the closet, as if someone had hung stuff up.
Oh, we're going into another dimension.
Yeah. Like, it's Narnia.
TJ Maxx.
What's going on up there?
Oh, okay. I don't know. Do I check for traps? I feel like a closet.
You can't check for traps?
You can't check for traps.
A closet? There's probably a cloaker in there, let's be honest. Like,
okay.
You're going to get checked by every classic D&D monster. A cloaker, a mimic. It's just...
Oh, yeah.
I don't even know what that is.
Check for traps.
Basically, it's a monster that looks like an ordinary piece of furniture.
That's a thing?
Yes.
Okay.
What your character knows, what your player knows.
Yeah.
That's called metagaming.
Yeah.
But since I'm new to this, wouldn't my character know my world since I don't know my world?
No,
so my character
would
know
one
more than I would know? But my character knows what a mimic is, right?
Not really, you haven't been doing much adventuring.
But her character
but
probably still would
what,
know
you can
more
make a
than
nature
she does.
Check.
Right?
I'll allow you to make a nature check to see if you know what a mimic is.
But I feel like I'm
you can just check for traps because
travel
you're a rogue.
Yeah,
I would say just make a perception check.
Yeah, okay.
No
yeah,
more
I'd like to
shit
check for traps, please.
Okay.
Please.
Can you roll inside the dice tray?
Oh,
that was a good roll.
We'll take the roll.
I don't.
Okay.
Don't roll in the dice tray.
Okay. Roll in the dice tray.
What are we doing?
No, 13 is good.
Just give her a plus 10 bonus.
13.
Why not?
All right, fine. 23. You found no traps.
I will take the check for traps, please.
Okay. Okay. You got a torch, so you're checking for traps,
no,
and you light
kidding.
The felt on.
You need to light everything on.
Yeah, actually, your character probably would light everything
on. Oh, guys. I'm doing the best I can.
Okay.
I don't know if that's a voice anymore. I don't remember.
All right, guys. I don't see anyone. We're going into a closet. I don't see any traps, and my moss doesn't see anything.
Your moss sees nothing.
My moss sees nothing.
Oh, let's put on the clothes.
Well, the only thing behind me is an ogre, so I think
yeah,
we should
so let's
keep
all,
going.
We're
going
to keep
what,
going.
What do these clothes look like? Are they big clothes, like for a giant, or is they normal clothes for like a...
For me.
They're for... Well... For, I mean, they could be for... They could be for anyone. Non-discriminating well, clothes.
Are they large size or
medium? Sounds like you're defending the clothes. In a very
are you
PC
examining
manner.
The clothes?
Well, yes.
Okay, yeah. There we go. You reach up and you grab the clothes.
Yeah, am I? Are the clothes gonna eat me like the cube?
No. I don't know. We'll see. That's why I have to.
You
ask,
have scared
dude.
A player into inaction.
Yeah. I'm trying to get you to the point where you say, "Fuck you, Mason. I'm doing this."
Could never. Well, apparently I flipped Sean off like the other
that
week.
That was
so
amazing.
Bad. I didn't know I was doing that. Anyway, yes, I'm examining the clothes.
Wonderful. You examine the clothes, and they are just human-sized clothes, robes mostly.
Okay.
Yeah, medium-sized. Looks like they could fit anyone in the party. Might be a little tight on Barky, but that's about it.
I'm a human.
Yeah, you are. Human-sized.
Yeah.
Okay. Are you a wizard, though?
Oh, you're a barbarian.
Do these look like wizardy robes?
Oh, my muscles are too big.
Give me an arcana check. Does this look like something a wizard would wear?
Well, does this look like a 16?
Not necessarily
I'm a sorcerer.
No, I mean, nice robes, but not necessarily wizards.
We're entering the lair of a judge.
Cool. Okay, well, we go in.
Let's proceed.
Yeah. So who's... All right.
Same
so
marching
so
order.
So you move yourself in?
Yep.
9 p.m. We have conquered the closet.
Right?
It's like that time stamp.
You step into this room. It is well lit. There are three chests sitting to the far wall. One of them is banging around furiously.
A chest.
There is a bed to the left over yonder and a desk to the right of it. On the desk there are rolls of paper, a map stands posted against the wall, similar to the one that you guys saw in Swadohas' room.
With
circles and X's on different mountain ranges.
Swadohas, I just want you to know how happy I am that you're with us now.
You're a true friend, Barky.
The chests, are they like treasure chests?
They come up to about 2 to 3 feet high.
Okay.
Yes, they do look like they could be treasure chests. Once again, one of them is rattling like crazy.
There's a person in there, probably.
Okay. We'll say it's
or an animal.
See,
or
this
an animal,
one is
yeah.
rattling. The other two are perfectly still, so what do you do?
I walk up to the one
I
that's...
I want to read the map.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Once again, you read the map, and it looks exactly identical to the one in Swadohas'
exactly.
room.
Exactly.
I read it again.
It looks exactly like the one in Swadohas' room.
And I read it one more time.
And it changes okay. miraculously to
Hold
the one
on.
That is in Swadohas' room.
Okay.
I want to examine the papers on the desk.
Okay. So you go through the papers, and it, a lot of it... doesn't seem like anything you understand. It's written in a different language. Some of it doesn't look like it's any language. Like it's just
gibberish.
Some of them are loose sheets. Some of them have diagrams on them. Give me an arcana check while you're trying to read this.
Mason.
Yes, sir.
We just got a donation from Blue Water Baron.
Blue Water Baron.
Blue Water Baron.
Thank you.
He gave you a reroll.
Oh, yeah.
What? On
we have
Earth
more of those
happening.
One tokens.
Yes, we do.
He's an evil person.
I want this.
What
oh.
is that? No.
Yes.
You don't even know. You don't know us.
Thank you.
We're not
20
good at this.
On the other side.
He's fine.
Yeah. I'm going to write Mason has a reroll. I'm going to go ahead and put down a rule right now. You cannot use a reroll against someone else's reroll. So if I reroll a thing, Tom can't go, I'm going to reroll your thing, or vice versa. I can't negate his reroll.
Okay.
That's
yeah, I assume it's just for me, right?
All
right,
or I'm
going to
put a roll down that you can never use your reroll.
I'm going to put on a rule that you can't neg anyone just in life.
That's fine.
All right.
Are you sure you want to wear that sweater?
I just got that. That was super mean.
I'm sorry.
It was a nagging.
That was not a neg. Neg is like, oh God, I hate that I even know what a neg is.
I haven't been married long
Everyone
enough.
Everyone knows. It's not worth talking about.
Are you saying neg or nag?
Neg.
Neg. Neg.
Like nagging you, right?
Yeah. Oh no.
Nag.
Neg.
Or is it like a word? Like negative?
No, it's pickup artist stuff.
Oh no.
I'm sorry.
It's just bad.
You may have just told.
You've experienced
more.
It. Trust me. I guarantee both of you have experienced it.
Wait. What is
there's
neg?
A difference? Because
I know nag. I don't know
neg. It's like
how about
when,
that D&D,
it's
when, folks?
Okay. God damn it!
But now why does
it
know what it is?
I'm not trying
but
to
I
do
think
this.
Like Sean teaches us something every episode.
And then you flip him off.
Mr. Rogers.
Okay. A neg is done by PUA's pickup artists, men who are awful people. Always. There is not a single redeeming quality to any PUA. And they will basically say something negative to a woman and put just enough positive in it to make it seem like a compliment, but it is basically them being an asshole.
So
I did do it.
It's a backhanded compliment.
That was, okay, good. Well, that's not great, but whatever.
Anyway, it's a whole thing.
So that's what you guys find on the.
And that's a tactic to get women?
Yeah.
It's terrible.
Yeah,
it's terrible. So over to you, Sean. What are you doing?
Before I open the chest, I'm gonna go up to the chest and be like, "Hey, is there a person in there?"
You get no response, but it continues to bang around.
Okay, well, I'm not gonna open it up if they're not gonna respond.
Wow.
That, it might be an animal. So oh God! Hey. But if it's an animal, they could be hurt.
It's true.
It's true.
Hold on, I'm gonna let everyone else go, and then I'll come back around to you. Okay. Sir.
So we've examined the desk.
Yes, sir.
Let's
examine the bed.
Like to examine the bed, yes. I need to rest, maybe.
That's a bed. It's nice.
What's
it's
underneath the bed is what I'm curious
underneath
about.
Underneath the bed, you look underneath it. It's clean. Doesn't look like there's anything. Slippers. You find slippers.
I'm so tempted right now. Are they my size?
Yes, they are your size. They fit comfortably if you put them on. Do you put on the slippers under the bed?
I don't want to.
Super dangerous.
I don't want to steal a judge's slippers right now.
A judge.
We will come back.
So I'm the last one out of the closet. So
yeah.
I want to.
We were expecting it.
I know. But I want to find something like that looks really nice in the closet, like a nice
very ornate robe or something.
Yeah, like a nice shirt, a nice shirt.
Tunic.
A nice tunic.
Ooh, nice tunic. Let's
you know,
see
something,
if there's a
something
nice
real fancy looking.
Like a good purple blouse.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, fuck it. I've got a coin for this. I've got a campaign coin I can use.
Something with like fur.
Yeah. There's a nice furry ornate tunic. Just your size.
Oh,
like you have the one arm that's a little longer, but it fits perfectly.
One arm is a little longer?
It's like half an inch, you know? You never really noticed it. It's for a fight. It's just fighting hand.
Oh, okay.
It's to stab people easier.
Right. Oh, yeah.
What
yeah.
judge stabs people?
He's got a gavel, doesn't he?
Sweet.
You can't stab someone with it. Well, I suppose
you're not trying hard.
Wow. You look great.
This is a very violent judge.
You look great.
I know.
I hope that anyone in chat... please, draw a picture of what that tunic looks like.
Yeah.
We'd love to have that. We'll post it up on our Facebook wall and our Twitter. Just get it out there and get your art
It better be fancy.
And fur-lined.
Fur-lined.
It's got fur, like a fur-line, yeah.
Fur collar?
Yeah.
Or lining on the
Does it
well,
have...
like, both.
And it kind of flails out?
Yeah, exactly. It's like the got lining it. That kind of comes out of the collar, you know? And
does it have embroidery or brocade?
Ooh.
I wish I knew what brocade was.
Well, embroidery means...
I know what embroidery.
Thread.
Okay, what's brocade?
Well,
piping.
Yeah.
Piping, isn't
piping.
It?
Piping. It means piping.
I don't know that.
Little round circle. It's like a round. It's like.
Is that like a smoking jacket?
It's like
a,
it's type? Like, it's
you know what?
Like
they're watching us on the internet. You can just look up what brocade is.
I'm not on the
brocade.
Internet.
Brocade.
I might be
asking.
They're
gonna find like a bros
asking.
Arcade. They'll find a brocade.
Brocade.
I want to say embroidery. I want to say embroidery.
A brocade is like a
just
motorcade
I don't
of bros.
Trust brocade. Brocade.
This judge really has a strange social life.
He's just nagging everyone.
So I've got my sweet.
Chicks
oh
brocade.
No! Is everyone dressing up without me?
So I got my sweet tunic.
I'm not dressing up. I don't know what he's doing.
All right, Amy, what are you doing?
Is everyone dressing up without me?
So he's come out. He's got a very, very lush. Very
are we taking
nice.
A family picture?
No, we're not taking a family
oh
picture.
Good.
We're not a family.
We've been together for two adventures now. Sessions.
I've ruined everything. No. Why did I open my mouth and ask a question?
No, Arky, I'm not. It's fine. We're a family.
Oh, I thought you said something
different. Nope. I said the opposite. I said...
Oh, it's opposite day.
It's opposite day. That's why I said it.
Oh, what fun.
No, it won't be. It absolutely won't be.
Because it will.
Oh, my God. Amy. Thank you for that. Birba, what are you doing? Atutska. She's dying.
I can't even.
Sorry. What was I doing? I was looking at the papers.
Yeah, she was looking at the papers on
the desk. You said there were some diagrams. I can't, like, is it like a part of a big diagram? I'm trying to rearrange it to see if it, like, makes something.
You start moving them around. Give me an intelligence check.
Yeah.
And add your intelligence modifier.
Oh, bloody hell.
What was it?
I feel like the coins aren't helping.
Oh, yeah, so it's six.
You're like, this means something. You're channeling Robert Langdon, and you're just not getting anything.
The coins are like, they're like the outer edge of a deathmatch.
She's making an arcana check?
No, yeah, just an intelligence check, trying to see if there's a hidden puzzle in there.
Oh, I see. Like an investigation?
Yeah.
I'll take a look at it.
It's like a wall.
Oh, well, I wouldn't say investigation, but... It was eight.
So what?
Investigation. She's trying to piece together a puzzle. I guess.
Yeah. Well, there's a puzzle. It would have made eight. Would that make a difference? Yeah. No.
Oh my gosh.
I'll take a 15.
You start moving the papers. You guys start working together on this, and it just doesn't mean anything.
Oh yes, it does.
Okay, I think I have something that could help.
Fire.
The chest that's like shaking or whatever.
Yes, sir.
Does it look like it's locked?
Do you want to try and open it?
Yes.
Okay. Then I want to ready.
It is locked.
Oh. Okay. Does it look like I could take my axe and break the lock?
Well, totally.
Well, I can. I've got some thieves' tool. We can pick the lock.
Oh, do that.
Yeah, I guess.
I want to ready. Okay, I want to ready in action though, in case anything jumps out. I want to just grapple. Just like hold it.
Okay.
If something jumps out.
Good. Gelatinous cube.
Yeah. I'll grab the
Sure. Gun. Yes, but I don't think.
Here's the thing. Gelatinous cubes don't like bounce around unless it's like. The toaster in Ghostbusters 2.
I was thinking flubber, but yeah.
Okay. Well, I'm gonna ready in action to grab whatever it is.
Okay.
No matter what.
What is the check for that? For unlocking?
For that one, I believe.
Sleight of hand.
Sleight of hand. Yes. Sleight of hand. And rogues have like a bonus to that.
Well, you get to add your proficiency bonus if you don't already have it.
I'm proficient.
Yeah.
His hands are slight.
Right. I'm like a roguey bard.
Bardy Rogue.
Bardy Rogue.
You find a mind flare.
Nice.
19.
The lock click opens up. The lid opens. And a cat jumps out.
And I catch him.
You catch it. And it's missing a little chunk of its ear.
Oh, God.
Looks kind of mangy.
Oh, my gosh. Are you a person?
They're making clothes out of cats.
I can.
The fur is very similar.
I can ritual cast... the speak with animals. So if we got 10 minutes, I can sit here and try to figure out.
Yeah, ask a cat what the fuck.
I can ask the cat what happened.
I would
to
love
it.
That.
Oh, are you part of our family?
All right. So
no.
While I mean, so this is gonna take like 10 minutes. So y'all are gonna be doing all this stuff.
We're gonna be chanting.
Well, I'm just gonna be like
candles. Yeah. Hold on, guys.
Yeah,
I gotta like do this
little
with the cat.
I'm making a friend.
You actually really need a dog more than a cat.
You don't know me.
You don't know.
Barky does need a pup.
I'm just saying, a dog is unconditional. A cat's like, now's not good for me.
That's true.
Do you have a dog?
You play the role of the cat.
No, I don't have a dog. I'm sorry.
Okay.
I mean, cats are awesome.
Okay, so you're going to go ahead and start.
So, yeah.
I'm going to make that cat talk.
I'm going to make that cat talk.
All right, cool. Tom, what are you doing, sir?
I will, having found a pair of slippers, I'm going to look down the hallway and maybe give a good listen and see if anyone is aware of our presence.
Okay. Go ahead and give me a perception check.
Smart.
Perception.
Mm-hmm.
Hi.
I think you have a listen skill in this, right?
No. No.
Didn't think so.
21.
Nice. 21.
Oh, wow.
You don't hear anybody, but you do hear the splashing of water.
he's taking a shower right now. He's going to come back and put clothes on. Quick, put everything back in the closet. Hide under his bed.
Oh, dude.
We'll each hide in a box.
I've often thought the worst time to defend yourself
is naked after a shower.
Is naked after a shower. That's like, the best shit, time. They try to murder me right now. I'm screwed.
Yeah. You have often thought this?
I hang out outside of his window waiting for him to go into a shower, and I just lurk there.
Yeah, well, just because a lot of times when you're taking a shower, it's dark outside because it's so early in the morning, and like when it's dark, you're like, fuck, somebody could break in and murder me.
I'm going to feed my cat.
I want to live in your mind.
And yet I don't.
Not long, no.
Just like an hour.
I want to explore a little.
I want to get one of those timeshares in your mind.
I am selling right now.
Oh, good. Right. I will take two.
I'm going to feed my cat. Feed my cat.
Wow, it has become your cat very quickly.
And describe it again. You said something.
It's a black kind of mangy cat. It looks like it's very malnourished. It's missing a chunk of the ear. It looks like it has probably been in the box for a good while.
I'm going to name you Skillet.
Skillet. All right.
So Skillet's its name.
Okay. All right.
And I'm feeding it and trying to get it to warm up to me.
All right. Have you ever tried to feed a cat?
Probably not.
Sniff at it and just gonna ignore it entirely.
Well, if
it's meat,
not
they might
starving.
Like it. Yeah, it could be starving. Is this cat starving?
Are you feeding it meat or your rations?
Meat.
Meat? Okay, it eats it up, no problem.
Okay. Oh, good job.
Good job eating. I fed you something you enjoy.
Good job.
Congratulations.
Do you guys think there are dead cats in the other ones?
Oh, no.
Oh, God. Well, now there's only one way to find it's Schrodinger's treasure chest.
We need to get a t-shirt made.
Can we look back at your treasure chest? Is there also a dead cat in that treasure chest?
In the one that just got opened?
In the one that locked.
It doesn't matter what you roll on pick locks. It's whether you make your perception
there
check.
There are no dead cats in the one that has been opened, but there are a few vials at the very bottom. Do you guys take those vials?
Oh, yeah.
Take
how many vials?
Well, I'm busy. We'll say six. Doing my little
six? Are there any that are purple?
Does that matter?
Yes.
Sure.
Yes, I grab a purple one.
Good.
Oh.
It's my favorite color.
What do you do the rest of them?
I don't know. Leave them there.
Can I make an arcana check to perhaps identify?
I'm going to uncork one and smell
it.
That
sounds
useful. That smells
not
purpley.
My job here, but.
No. Smells purpley.
Whatever your favorite flavor is.
Oh, yes!
Did you say whatever my favorite flavor is?
Yeah, it smells like it. Yeah.
Oh, well, then for sure I'm going to take a sip.
Nice. Are you 44?
22.
No, 22.
I was going to do this 11 times.
I was like, 2, 4.
So it smells like raspberry.
The raspberry, yeah.
Then I take a sip of the raspberry drink.
Oh, you feel any damage you took last game? Go ahead and heal about 2 points of it just for taking a sip. They're health potions, minor heal potions.
Wow.
Six of them.
All right.
That tells you what Mason has planned.
Oh,
by the way,
guys,
the cat's a girl.
Are you sure?
Just found it.
Okay, I think it.
How
is.
Can you tell
about that?
I know. I lived around animals.
Okay,
I'm
still doing your thing,
Outlander.
Focusing.
Yeah.
What are you guys doing?
I want to ask Sudohas is with us if he, you said there's a map on the wall that's identical to his. If he knows of anyone that's following along the same adventures as he is.
He looks baffled. He's like, no one should know about this. I called you guys here because I'm looking for a ley line. It's a path to another dimension. If we can cross through it.
Did we do
so
it?
Someone else's.
I don't think so. I mean, when cats start talking, that might get a little weird, but I think we're still in ours. Different planes, different dimensions are vastly different.
Mm. Can you prove it?
Not yet. That's why I was hoping you guys would help me, but.
Someone's following along the same path as that you've already done, obviously.
That's terrifying, yeah.
Okay.
What if there's someone else who's after the book that I got? Oh, well.
The book? Have.
Yes, the one that the what's the word? Acquired from the local.
Purloined.
Lord. Purloined.
Liberated.
Liberated. Is a good word.
Very familiar with that word.
Yep.
Yes.
We liberated this cat.
That is actually the correct usage. Yes, you did. You did liberate that cat.
We purloined this cat.
This cat is purloining in my arms.
Purloin the feline.
So, what else are you guys going to do in this room?
Open the other chest.
Yeah, well,
he's chanting.
I'm
he's focused. He can't do it.
All right, I will. Actually,
the thief's probably
open.
Got.
Yeah.
probably got a
You can try and pick the lock on him, or I
so
can
use
chest.
So which chest are you going to do, the middle one or the one far to the right, nearest me?
And they're all identical?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, okay, the one nearest you.
Okay. All right.
Is it a...
Sleight of hand.
Sleight of hand, okay. Mm-hmm. Five. I don't know.
Six.
It's a six?
Yeah, it's a six. If the dot's at the bottom, that's...
Yeah, it's at the bottom. Yeah, and then plus, I guess, five. I always forget. Is it plus three or plus five?
If you got your proficiency, then it should
it's
be plus
five.
Probably.
Or is it three?
Proficiency bonus plus two, so it's plus five.
Okay, it is. Okay,
so 11. Yeah. Back where we started. All right. As you are picking it, the lid opens up, springs open. A dart comes flying at your head, whizzes right by you, inches away.
Nice.
That's
a close call.
Sticks against the back wall.
Okay. Good.
Anything in there?
I guess immediately after, did I shut it, or is it? Are there?
That's
is
entirely.
It
just,
I mean,
just
that's
happened really
that's
quick.
Be,
yeah. Okay.
Click, click.
That's it, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
I feel like that basically would have been your reaction. Is basically like you open it, and you're like, well, that was close.
Oh. Yeah. No, that was my reaction. Genuinely, I was like, okay, well,
that happened.
That's a thing.
We did good.
Nerves
are dead. Cat in there.
Yeah. So I look. Do I look in?
You open this one up, and it looks like it's entirely built just to be a dart trap. There's nothing inside of it.
Okay.
I'll be honest. A little malicious.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yes, but a handy thing to have around when you're showering.
Good point.
They're looting your stuff, trying to kill you. Like, I'm gonna hide this trunk.
Keep the party that's just invaded your home busy while you shower.
This is why I don't.
You grab your gavel and start stabbing people.
Go to the next one. You already said you basically disarmed the trap already by having it happen.
Yeah, because I didn't think that because I couldn't search for a trap without opening it.
You
right.
Could've.
So
that's what I was having. Essentially, when you're doing your lock picking,
I'm
checking to see if you notice the mechanics of the trap while you're opening it. If you rolled a lot higher, then you would have been like, "That's a trap right there."
Okay. So
but
I don't have to say like, "I want to check for traps while opening."
As a rogue, not really.
Okay. Okay.
Oh.
So I'd like to open the next one.
Okay.
That's what you're doing. Yeah, I'm like
pretty good.
So 23.
Thank you.
Give me a perception check, please.
A perception?
Mm-hmm.
A
19. 19? Oof. You go to pick this one, and it doesn't look quite right. You're inches from it.
It's a mimic.
When it all of a sudden opens up. And this thing starts gnashing at your hand.
No!
It's a
mimic.
It's
I wanted
tongue
to know
lashes
what a mimic
out to
was.
Get you.
Yeah, you know
you
this
found
is
out.
Very educational.
This is
does a 15 hit your AC?
This is gonna mess up my
man. Yes, it does.
The tongue lashes out, sticks to your hands, mere feet from it, and it's going to try and pull you in.
Okay, this is where I have to tell you, like, I'm screaming and I'm trying to get away. Can I hack at it? Can I?
Yes, now we jump into initiative. It's grappling you at the moment. Next turn, it's going to try and pull you in.
So much for that ritual.
Oh, how far along were we on that?
I don't know.
I'd say
the thing that worries
like three,
me the most
in.
Is that during this combat, you are not going to be able to speak with cats. Just to be clear.
Once again, just a weekend. In
no.
there.
Wait, is this Skillet, one? Go under the bed.
Son of a bitch. Well, it is now, I guess.
All right, so we should roll initiative, right?
Sorry.
Yeah, let's roll initiative. Well,
initiative, please.
I'm an awful person. Just in general.
I don't roll
I'm
right
because
so I'm grappled.
Yeah,
oh, I do?
Yeah.
I thought
what a son of a bitch I am.
He's looking at the world address.
Okay.
Is it just seven, right?
Plus.
Oh, I forget. Okay.
I'm going to put my beer over here.
Do.
Because
sure? Sometimes when you have identical beers.
Yeah. I don't think that's a good excuse for me. It was very clearly right here, and I have one right here. Not an issue of identical looking beards. Issue of me being real retarded.
real retarded. I love that.
It's okay, I'm just dumb.
Are we rolling for initiative?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Yep.
Oh, my life is so great right now.
Okay.
Yes,
everyone
15.
Rolled?
Yep.
25 to 20.
Ugh.
Anybody in that range? Nope. 20 to 15. What do you guys know?
17.
17?
18.
Hold on. 17. Tom, Amy. What'd you get, sir?
12.
12. Well, that's less than. Okay.
It's less, yes.
Mm-hmm. All right. 15 to 10, which is where you would be.
Yep.
Nope.
Oh, 10? Yes.
10. 10 Atutska. Where'd you land, Sharon?
5.
5. Mm.
Good I rolled job. A 5.
Good job, buddy.
Well,
do you have a plus? You don't have it.
I have a 0. Yeah. But you know what? It's not a negative 1. I've played a lot of characters who have a negative 1 initiative.
Weird.
8 dexterity?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, because you play heavy fighters.
Who it's almost like, always.
What for?
Yeah.
I need strength. I need hit points. I don't need to be fast.
What do
fast.
I care? Let's just take a bunch of hits.
Like the mountain.
Oh, my yep. gosh. Oh, my gosh.
Mountains are great, though. So.
Okay, let's rearrange this initiative order a wee bit. Actually, Udo going
yes.
first.
Oh my god.
Udo.
We'll start
it's
over
true.
Here.
Just because I can. Nope.
Master one. Oh, monster.
Yes, master one. Dungeon
We're already
master.
Fighting masters, yes.
The masters of
Wait,
the dungeon.
Wait, I got 17.
Oh, sorry, I got a Tutska. Mixed up you guys with your A names.
Yeah.
There's three of them.
Okay.
I know.
Yep.
You don't really have a good excuse there because one of those is in English. The other one is in Rascal's font. So you should really
I was
going to
think Windings. Okay.
That's how I write my name.
Udo.
Here, give me a look at that gibberish. I bet I can make some sense. Oh, this is just a letter I wrote.
It's a diary.
Yeah, this is my diary.
Dear diary, today I almost had a family.
Oh, oh. They ate my cat.
She's got three volumes that all say the same thing.
Cool.
I
my
will.
Left me.
I will cast Ray of Frost on it. I think.
Okay.
Cool.
You're frosting that ray.
Hopefully it doesn't have a good armor class because I only got an 11.
I'm sorry, you missed.
Dadgummit.
Okay.
Ducks under. Are you going to move at all? Well, there's nowhere to move, but yeah.
No, I'm in the back of the room. I feel happy.
Particular?
You can make a nature check to see if you know what a mimic is and if it's weak to anything. Hey,
I got a 7 nature check.
Good for you.
That looks scary.
Cool.
That's
I got
what
a
I know.
Five.
I know that that's
that's
scary.
Cray.
That's Cray. So.
I got a 7 too, and I'm like, he's right. This
he's
thing
right.
is scary.
I got,
scary.
I got a 5, and I'm like, I trust everybody.
I got a 17.
Arky.
He wants to be my friend.
Arky's trying. Arky thinks he's a new member of our family.
Okay, so,
look, Kat, I found your brother.
Just so you know, the skillet's under the bed, right? I let skillet hide or whatever.
Oh, the skill's getting the F out of there.
Skill's going
sure.
into the shower to wake up the gym.
So I'm going to greatsword it.
Okay.
Yeah, greatsword it.
And that'll Does, be...
Yeah.
Hold on. Arky, where are you at?
Oh, I'm here. Oh, so I have to be somewhere?
You have to be close to it to be able to hit it.
All right.
If you flip the table onto the bed...
Okay,
I'll just stand there.
Thank you. That's what I do. All right.
So much, kill it.
So much for the element of surprise.
Oh, okay. 17
armor class.
That's what you rolled? Yeah, you hit.
Yes. So for not bad, 11 damage.
Ooh.
I rolled a 6 and a 3.
Nice.
That's beautiful. Math. It is a thing that I should use more.
Math. We're just going to keep that amongst ourselves.
Yes.
There's no reason for you to not get that
it
reference.
It does not die.
Does it completely deteriorate? Okay, that's okay. My turn.
Good job. All right, this thing's going to try and bite you. You can do nothing except for be bitten.
You can do nothing!
Nothing! 20 versus AC.
Sure. What is this thing?
I rolled really high.
Okay.
So
yeah.
I would
yeah.
know.
Does
yeah.
that hit?
I cast reroll on you.
You can't cast reroll on me.
Right, that's what was
Donate,
it?
Donate, and then you can cast reroll.
What was that asshole name that gave it to him?
Who's
that asshole?
Blue.
Hey, he's my favorite person
nah.
at the moment.
No.
You know
what?
Second only to live to game.
Okay.
Blue Water Baron.
Blue Water
Baron.
Baron.
You know what?
Oh, you know what? He's a Baron, so he's a big fan of the rich getting richer.
Don't
1%.
Hate. Don't
okay,
hate.
So you hit.
I do.
Yes, Friday.
So, go ahead and take 7 points of damage.
What? That is insane.
What are you doing, Arky? Arky, what are you doing?
You gave insane so many syllables.
Arky, stop.
No.
I'm attacking Virva.
7. Oh my god.
Oh my gosh. Okay, I thought you said, because it was my
turn. Still, that's even more.
Because it was my turn, and you just were using like impersonal pronouns. You kept saying you, and
I'm so sorry.
And it's always about me.
And it's always about me. Well, I mean, listen.
Atutska also take 1 point of acid damage.
Oh my gosh.
What's that?
Acid.
We about to have a demo on our hands.
Take 1 more point of damage.
Oh my god.
That's caused by acid. If you have some sort of resistance to acid,
you're at 1 hit point.
I have 1 hit point.
Okay. Good. It'll have something to eat.
I'll
come for you, Donovan.
I know.
Come
okay.
for you.
This is good okay. Luck. This could be worse.
Asher, it's your turn. What are you doing, sir?
Point of view.
I'm going to attack it. Since I'm already next to it,
oh, wow.
I've got the rapier dagger, so I guess.
Does someone want to draw? Oh, there it is. On the other side.
I made amazing. A monster.
That's amazing.
Thank you.
I draw from life.
You know what? Take an
Wait, something's going to happen.
Tom? Take an inspiration for that.
Ooh!
Yes. Oh my gosh, he's got two inspiration points.
I've got two.
Points.
No, he only has one inspiration point. And he has one.
Oh yeah, he's got
one reroll.
Yes, he's got two.
All right. Yeah. So attacking with a double attack.
No,
if I don't move, I can double attack, right?
Yes, sir.
That's just how it works.
I chose this.
When you attack with two weapons and you don't have two weapons fighting,
a mimic.
You do
mimic
your chest. Attack
That's
and
really
it.
Good.
You get your
ability score bonus. I'm very afraid of that.
It's earning. It's eating
my flesh. Yes, it is.
For the damage.
I would hire you.
For the damage.
Yes.
Okay. Oh. Gotcha.
Yes. Attack!
What was the
does
question?
Does that use a bonus action to do the second attack?
Yes, that's why you're not moving.
Interesting. Okay, so in that case, I might want to just do a regular attack and then use my bonus action.
Okay.
To bardically inspire Atuska.
So you're stopping your chanting?
Yeah. I mean, he has to. Yeah, yes. I'm not gonna.
Shit! Kill it!
There's
Kill
a
it.
Mimic that.
Don't worry, the cat understands everything you're saying.
You know what?
So the attack.
See Skillet, and it looks at you. There's a knowing glance.
Does a.
Skillet's one of us.
Oh, jeez.
Does a 12 hit?
A 12? Does hit.
Yay!
Yes! Oh, you
missed by one!
Oh, Tom.
So angry right now. So
if only you had a reroll token you could have used. Plus
three. Hey!
Ooh.
That's 11 damage.
You guys are chopping this thing up.
It's eating me up. Oh my gosh, you got 11 damage too?
Yeah.
Yes.
Part of the old ones club.
And so I will give you a bardic inspiration. So you have a d6 to add to an attack or save.
Here you go.
Fancy D6. Oh. Ooh, that's a pretty one.
So
if you want to use it.
Next time you make an attack or save, if it's low, you can toss that extra
D6. What's a save?
Saving
like
throw.
It's trying to swallow you. You're
yes.
I don't want to be swallowed.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Or poisoned. Or mind controlled.
Those
and things
that's
can happen.
Turn.
Okay. Thank you.
Good turn.
You
awesome. Good turn.
Good job.
Atutska. You got messed up good.
Well, yeah, what can I do if I'm
You
grappled?
Can try and break free of the grapple.
Uh-huh.
You just have to make a, I believe, dexterity check for that. Escape check.
Either athletics or acrobatics.
Either one of those, whichever is higher for you.
Probably
so
acrobatics.
Acrobatics is higher.
Okay, great.
Okay, so, but if I try to do that, won't it try to, what's that,
it's
attack
going to
of
eat
opportunity?
You regard, no.
Oh, no, okay.
No.
Again, so 11?
11, unfortunately. You're unable to break free.
No.
Sorry.
You want to use your inspiration, your D6, to boost that?
Yeah, I guess.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Have confidence.
Oh,
I'm not 12. Rolling really good.
12.
12.
Its strength is probably better than 12.
Yeah.
I would imagine.
Yeah, sorry.
But
I'm so gonna kill your character every single game.
Yes, you are.
You're supposed to kill Sean tonight.
I know, but he didn't touch the box. I thought he was going to.
First of all, yes, I did. I was super into the first box. You're the one that made the first one friendly.
it's
don't put this on
right.
me.
You're very right. I should have switched things
true.
At the last minute.
You should have to punish me.
Why do you think the box was shaking back and forth? Because it was a mimic.
Yep,
that's why.
I mean, you rewarded a player for opening a pushing us to open a shaking box.
Yeah.
Like,
things aren't as they appear.
Also rewarded a player for
didn't
drawing
we each get
the
a vial?
Evil thing.
Well, he didn't pass them out. He found them.
Oh, yeah. Come on, man.
What? Huh?
Yeah. About the vials, though, the healing potions?
Oh, yeah, no,
you guys
I drank something, but I did not know what
I looked
was.
At them.
He had no
yeah.
problem with that.
But you guys didn't pass them out or anything.
No.
Well, you were busy
which.
Talking to your cat.
Well, or take them.
Donovan,
I
this is your turn.
I'm going to lay into the box. With my great axe.
I just looked at them from across
no,
the
with
room.
My great sword.
Yeah, healing potions.
So I draw my great sword and attack.
I don't need
okay.
that.
Why not?
I'm fine.
Everybody needs.
What do you mean? I have 8 hit points. Oh, everything's great.
12
everything's
to great. Hit?
Hits.
Nice. Oh,
it's been established at 12 hits.
Yeah. Yes.
It hurts.
Okay. Shit.
What?
6 one damage. And 1. 6 damage.
Dead.
No.
Dead. Come it.
Yeah, I know.
Udo.
What are you going to do, though?
What am I going to...
What are you going to do to Udo?
It's terrible.
I will Ray of Frost it again. That's an 18.
Sucker.
That's going to hit.
7 points of damage, and it loses 10 feet of speed.
Oh, nice. No, that's not good for it.
It's got nowhere to go.
It's going nowhere.
Is it dead?
No. Arky, your turn.
Okay, I have to heal her.
I imagine you don't know how vials work. You just like smash it into her.
I'm just going to use a healing kit.
Oh, thank you.
I have to use one of my healer's kits, so.
I think it's one use of a healer's kit, right? Mm-hmm.
I'm going to do
it. It's got
like
5 uses, right?
I think so, something like
that. No, I think it has 10.
Yeah. Oh, 10?
Yeah, 10, and I've used it twice, so I'm going to use it 3 times. And you can spend waste and restore 1d6 hit points plus 4.
Gotta make a plus her heal level. Check, though.
Oh, heal check.
Yep.
Okay.
Do they not have heal on here? Why is that so?
Medicine,
that's what it is.
Okay.
All them terminologies. Hey, 20. 20, that'll do it.
That'll do it, plus 5. You get 5 hit points back.
I think good. She gets awesome. Her level on top of awesome. That. I think okay. She gets 6.
Oh, really? And restore.
It's a d6.
Well, for a healer's kit, it's not a spell.
Yeah.
It's 1d6 plus 4 hit points.
I'll take a look at
plus
it.
Plus additional hit points equal to the creature.
If only we had like a handbook for players.
Oh, the creature's maximum number of hit dice. So she's level 1, so
one. Six. So 6
okay.
total.
Good. Okay. Call. Thank you.
Okay, so you gave me 6. Yep. I gave you 6. Back at 7. Thank you.
And I glance 7. Over at Skillet.
Yes, Tyler.
A quick Tom and Amy, you get 1 more inspiration.
What?
Yes! Hogging it.
Unfortunately, there is a thing. You can only have 1 inspiration at a time.
Oh, great. I use it to attack. I use it right now to attack.
Yes.
Spend the inspiration.
16 hits.
Nice.
Yeah.
2d6 plus 2. 8, 10 damage.
Damn it.
Nice.
And I relinquished my inspiration point from Live to Game, and now I get a new one, right?
Yay. Yay.
It's the same one. I've chosen
thank
the dragon.
You.
Curses!
Space Colonizer.
Thank you!
Space Colonizer! That's an awesome name.
Yeah. Space Colonizer. You're on my list.
No, thank you. Thank
it's
you.
Still not dead.
Still standing.
That mimic.
Or squatting. It's a mimic. No.
Yes. Who's next?
But you have an inspiration point.
That would be the monster's turn.
No, he get because Mason gave him an inspiration point.
Oh.
So you got to use it real quick. And then get another one.
I will use it.
Yeah. Use it. Or share it.
Wait, why can we have only one?
That's the rules.
By the way, and also on my character sheet, I just put all.
I know. I know. I saw that, and I was going to say something to you, but I'm like, you know what? It's fine.
I have all the inspiration.
She's inspiring.
I feel like, especially in a situation where somebody who so smartly donates, I don't think the cap should be there.
I mean, but I'm just going to stop rewarding players.
Make
everything rely on
the one that you got.
It just makes you use the one you got.
You know what?
Put a cap at 2.
From this point on, I will not put a cap when people donate.
Yes. You can't.
But I'm going to strictly pull back any that I decide to give you guys.
That's fine.
Okay.
All right? Yeah. I'm going to rein that in.
I just think it's good for Space Colonizer, who, by the way, has a kick-ass name. Because I agree. Fuck not colonizing space.
Look at how many coins he has. We're winning.
So many.
Oh, shit.
Listen, guys, I'm saying this fight's too easy. We need people
to
come in here.
You're in luck.
Fight's
too easy. He just gave
$15. Oh! Yes! You know what?
$15.
We got a new baddie coming in.
Yes, you do.
Like a bunch of fighters, like,
hold on.
The door.
I gotta
Space
pull.
Space Colonizer!
No, that was 8769.
What is happening to my life? No, no caps on inspiration points. Ever again. Oh my god.
Someone
gosh.
Just chimed in.
All right, I'm just going to pull something from some random beasties.
Are we bad?
Why is this allowed?
All right, let me.
It's the judge's housekeeping staff.
You got to raise that price, man. That's got to be a lot more than $15.
Come on, you. Yeah, bully mungs.
Uh-oh.
What monster
I'm
is he
in front.
Getting?
This is not good for me.
No, it's not good for
this
you.
This is not, and I've already gone.
This does not bode well.
I just killed
okay.
The, well, good thing I killed the mimic.
How many do you how many do I get, guys? Is it one?
Three.
Just then, you guys hear, and they went this way, they killed our brothers. Yeah. Oh. As more kobolds come pouring in from the back.
They're in the closet, though.
The kobolds are bursting out of the closet as they do.
Now, hang on. Legitimately, they would stop to try some things on, right?
Who said that? They were doing that, and then they heard fighting erupt, and they're like, oh, shit, we'll do this later.
Hey, Grumpy, do you smell a cat?
I love cats.
Let's go eat some
cats. I haven't had cat in ages.
There are too many bad guys here.
Yeah.
If only you guys had some inspiration you could use to get extra attacks.
One of us does. Oh, I have one.
Time to crank up that charisma.
Okay, here we go.
Whose turn is it now?
Hold on. Let me. I got to roll for their initiative. Put them in there.
Stupid kobolds.
Listen, those are our fans.
Who donated this? I might give my inspiration point to a player.
Atuska,
I could
probably also got a reroll from Blue Water Baron.
Blue Water Baron, what are you doing? Whose side are you on, bro?
Yeah.
Come on.
That's a little more fair.
You can't play both sides.
Guys. This is a game.
That's not fair.
Blue Water Baron, you back in my camp. Yep. You back in Barkey's Brigade.
I'm starting to think Blue Water Baron is less of a baron and more of a pirate.
I know, right? He's
a spy.
Going either side.
He's a spy.
A spy, but a cool spy.
Is he a double agent for us or a double agent for him?
That's yet to be
seen. I don't think he's a double agent. I think he's for us, and he had to do some subterfuge and make him think that he's for him.
Not the worst of those.
Is it pronounced subterfuge?
I believe so, or it's going to be now. Subterfuge.
Subterfuge.
I know. Subterfuge. I honestly don't know.
Subterfuge.
That's how you spell it.
No, that's how you say it.
I think it's subterfuge.
I always thought it was subterfuge. It's subtle. But I'll be honest, I've never been confident
subtle
enough
is,
to say it out.
Subtle is said that
I think you can say it both ways. I'm going to Google it.
Subtle is said that way. Subterfuge is not said that way.
I say subterfuge.
Well, I think you might be the only one.
I'm from Texas, so I say things how I want.
That is true.
Thank you for the vamping, folks. Now
but
I've got the character
sheet. We knew what she was talking about, right?
True.
Yeah.
So
I think being a double agent is always better than being a single agent. Like,
11? Oh shit!
Just
you guys are
yeah. From a pure
it's
standpoint,
guys,
like,
it's subterfuge.
It is subterfuge.
Where did I get subterfuge from?
It's subterfuge.
Well, because
subtle.
Because
subtle
yeah, when you pronounce subtle, you say
when
subtle.
When you pronounce subtle, you say subtle.
But look at this. Look at the thesaurus synonyms. Okay, trickery, intrigue, deceit, deception, dishonesty, duplicity, guile, cunning, craftiness, chicanery.
I love chicanery.
Pretense, fraud, fraudulence. Such a great word, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, that being said, subterfuge is pretty awesome, too.
All right. Back to where we were. Arky went. I'm sorry. Where were we, actually?
We got
so monster attack. Monster's turn.
Attacking.
Monster 1 is going to eat you.
Yeah. Yeah, but too bad, because I healed her.
Well,
yeah, okay.
I put a band-aid on.
So it's trying to pull you in. It is not making any progress. Your feet are skidding as you're being pulled towards its gaping maw, gnashing teeth.
Good work.
But you're not, it's not able to pull you in.
That's good.
Yeah,
that's
good. For now. Okay. Still takes some acid damage, though.
Because that mimic is a fucking
what
failure.
What does acid damage do? Like, is it
like
one
acid.
Of those things that eat, actually, is it like flesh-eating bacteria? Is it like,
it's just it's doing just, damage, but it's just of acid
like
type.
If you were,
so
if,
you
you
have,
if you were immune to acid, like if you were maybe a dragon.
Yeah, right. So take 2 points of acid damage as you feel it burning into your skin.
Okay.
Oh, also,
yes, sir.
If you ever have the option, be a dragon.
We have a friend. That's his motto too. If you can be a dragon, be a dragon.
I do. I want
to be Batman.
I want to dual class and also dual race at some point. Mm-hmm. And
dual
I'll just turn myself into a dragon.
Nice. All right, Asher.
All right, I'm gonna.
You hear the screeching of kobolds who are terrible at stealth coming in from behind.
All right. Well, I'm gonna try to finish off the mimic.
I think that's smart.
Are you?
Yep.
Yeah. That's what I'm gonna do.
Yeah, this mimic.
Do I need to show you my arm again?
Woo!
Nice.
21.
We are rolling like badass.
I know. I'm going to have to kill you faster.
Hey, you know what? We roll deep.
What do you mean? You've got all these
kobolds. 10 damage.
10 damage. It's dead.
It's alive.
Come on! We have literally done like 60 damage.
Will you double check?
But I'm going to give you an inspiration.
Bardic inspiration.
Yes.
Take that green dice that I gave Vierva, because that doesn't stay with her, does it?
No, once she uses it, it's expense.
Yeah.
Okay.
Cool.
And this is for damage or saves?
It's for, yeah, for
D20
attack or save.
Okay,
reroll.
Attacker
save.
Or skills. You can use it for skills too.
Yeah, basically D20 rolls.
Yeah.
All right.
What? Skills aren't
Atuska. What are you going to do, Scott?
Trying.
Get out.
Yeah. Yeah, really. Trying to get out.
I don't feel great about that.
About me trying to get out?
I my rhyme. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
I do it all the time.
Atuska, what are you going to do, Scott?
Yes.
When it says Udo, what are you going to do?
If we do that consistently for the next however long,
the bard does not approve.
At some point, I will have to get on board.
Yeah,
okay. I just won't have a choice.
That took a turn.
So, I didn't expect that. Yes. On your turn, what would you like to do?
I'm trying to get out.
Yes, good.
You
want to
break the hold?
That's all I can do,
yes.
Right?
Yes.
Break the hold, yeah.
What you say? Yeah.
Like, you can like attack.
It's weird.
Whoa, nice. You're like, not today!
Oh, no, no, you're right.
Dex.
It's dex, right? It's acrobatics, right? 23?
Acrobatics.
23.
You break free, no problem. Just, Are you going to run?
Like Hulk rage.
Yeah, you can move.
If you move, it gets an attack of opportunity.
Right, but I have
a rogue thing.
Yeah, disengage.
Cunning?
Oh, yeah, you can take a cunning action.
Yes. Cunning, right? Disengage. So I can, should I disengage? Should I attack and then disengage?
What does that mean?
Can you take a cunning action to attack?
No, you
know. I'm saying she wants to do it. Action,
you take a bonus action, and you can do those few things that within the cunning action descriptor.
Here's my question.
So, like, attack and disengage, could I do that?
No, just disengage. Your normal action will be spent to attack, and then your bonus action would be spent to disengage.
Which you've already spent your normal action
to break okay.
Out. You could just move away.
Okay, but it would take an attack of opportunity if I don't.
No, because you're disengaging.
I see.
Doesn't
anyone else, because I don't have that skill, I would take an attack of opportunity if I did the exact same thing.
But you're taking a cunning action.
Disengage cancels the attack.
You're so sneaky.
Okay, yeah.
You're going to do that?
So, yes.
Go ahead
yes.
And move your speed away.
Well, I mean, there's
30 feet.
Tiny ass.
But she can move through you guys, because you're allies.
Yes. Right, but yeah. Where is she? I mean, where?
There's a hallway over here she can come down.
Isn't there a bed over there?
Yeah, stand on the bed.
She can stand on the bed, yeah.
Yeah, well, we're about to be attacked by...
Kobolds?
Yes, those.
She jumps on top of the bed where the desk is also there.
She's that's man.
Right. on top of it. That's fine.
It's another mimic.
You're on top of it.
It's another
from
mimic.
From one mimic into
yeah.
another.
Yeah. Because Tom checked under the bed. He didn't touch the bed.
Yeah, here's the thing. This is a bed
there mimic. It is. It's a bed mimic. Actually,
what? The bed turned into a mimic?
No, I'm fucking with you. I actually did send that to my friend. I was like, is two mimics too much? And he's like, yeah, it's too much. Level one. Don't do it.
Okay. Thank you, friend, whoever that is.
That would be Brian Haskell. He said, don't do it. Don't kill him.
Thank you, Brian.
I've met Brian. Brian's a nice
who's
guy.
After,
yeah. He sounds like it.
He's so much
after Atuska is going to be the Kobolds.
It's insane.
Kobolds.
Sorry, Kobolds. Sorry, Donovan. Kobolds rolling in deep. These two, since you're the only one they can attack wherever this is.
That's me.
That's you. You're going to get attacked.
All right.
The other Kobold's just going to hang out in the closet and wait
hope
for his
I don't
turn.
Die.
Me too.
How does that mimic?
First one's a miss. Second one is a dagger comes out from the curtains. 19 versus
that's
AC.
Hit me, yo.
Shoot.
Okay, good, good. I approve of this.
Hit me.
I can't do what I want to do.
What do you want to do? Take 5 points of damage.
All right.
As you feel something slide into your back.
Owie. Did the other one hit?
No. Thank
no,
you.
Ma'am. Missed, and the other one can't
the
reach
fact
anyone.
That you heard me say owie means that the other one did not hit it.
Okay. Yeah, that's true. He's still alive.
He's still alive.
Donovan.
Okay. Here's the thing about Donovan.
Oh, no.
He... Whoa.
Oh, I don't know. I just...
We're in awe.
You got, like, super, like, worried that I was going to, like, do something bad.
I want to know
what
the thing about Donovan.
I'm not going to
do anything bad. I don't know what the thing
is. Here's the thing about Donovan. Yes, this mimic is a problem, but I feel like the better way for me to protect... You know, my group here
retreat?
Is to charge into those three kobolds.
Okay.
So, is there any way for me to do that? Can I get any?
Fortunately, no. At best, you can maybe attack this one. Is that you right here? No, you're
no.
back over
yeah,
here.
You
no.
Not without taking an attack of opportunity from the mimic.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm such a fail as a leader for letting you just
kill that mimic. Kill that mimic.
Kill that mimic.
21.
Oh!
You hit. Roll some damage.
Yes, roll a lot.
Here's the thing, I'm not a chump.
Oh, yes.
So you're looking at 11, 14 damage.
14, that
yep.
is
enough to make
gonna
it
be up. Enough to kill it.
Yay! Yay! Oh,
yeah. Donovan,
yes.
Would you do me the honor of describing its death and your killing blow?
Yes, okay. So I come in and I just chop the treasure chest in
to
half.
To the camera, please.
Oh, I forgot the for audience. A second that we even have an audience.
I know, right?
Okay, so I come in and I chop the treasure chest in half.
With your what? With what?
With I'm using my great or no, my great sword.
Sword.
Yeah. So I come in with my great sword and chop it. My great sword, by the way, not super fancy, like super. This is a blue collar weapon. It's not super sharp. In fact, if this were like a human, I would almost feel bad about chopping it, like, because it's almost a little blunt even. I don't sharpen it very often. So I come in and I chop it, and then as soon as I go through, I'm like, oh god, I hope there's not a cat in there. Is there a cat in there?
No. Okay. You know what? Yeah, there's like three cats in there. You open
it up. Oh god.
And they escape unharmed.
Oh, no, then I'm happy.
Wait, my friends!
I grab a cat. Can I grab one of the cats?
Yeah, you can.
I also grab the rest of the cats.
You grab them by the scruff of their neck, you know, friendly like.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Skillet's over there.
Go to your family.
I'm gonna name this one Saucer.
Okay. Skillet, Saucer, is the other one gonna be Pot?
I don't get to decide that. I only get to decide the one that I grab. Somebody else grab one so you can name one.
Oh, everyone yeah. will have a band of
Colander?
Cats.
Breakfast.
Colander.
Colander.
Yes. Colander, Saucer, here's a Spork.
Spork.
Here's the mimic.
And a skillet.
Split in half now.
Yeah, right. For sure write those down.
And there Colander, are cats. It looks like he was feeding Spork. The cats to the mimic. Or she, whoever the person is.
This is the meanest judge ever.
Saucer and skillet. That's awesome. We have four
this
cats.
Have been an
you do. Are you guys going to keep that in a bag? How are you going to continue adventuring with
them? Yeah. What's how do you spell Colander?
Well, for
like
now,
Colander, but with two A's.
I'm going to keep mine in my pack.
C-O-L-A-N-D-E-R.
For now, we got three kobolds attacking me. So
yeah.
All right. So I will turn.
I could be making.
And I am going to frostbite.
It is
the one that I can see.
Hold on, guys. I got to hear this. What's up?
I'm going to cast frostbite on the kobold that I can see, who is attacking Asher.
All right.
And he needs to make a DC 13 Constitution. I think it's a Constitution save.
Constitution.
That sounds right to me.
Might be dexterity.
He succeeds.
Well, then nothing happens.
Unless it's higher than 21.
No.
Okay. Sorry, bud. Sorry. Arky?
Okay, Arky feels really great about that thing. Can I get the guy here through?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Who are you?
So it's just one entrance, right? It's just this thing. So he's going to die.
he does have to die.
All right. I'm going to just attack and then move out of the way. Ah, oh, damn it. 11.
D6. If only you had some sort of
D6. 11 plus 5. So 11 plus 5 is 16.
You're absolutely right. You hit.
I hit. Okay,
some damage.
So 2d6 plus 2. 5.
Describe its death.
Yes.
Nice.
Yay.
So I'm very skilled with my greatsword.
Obviously.
And so I can only get him through a crack, or else I'm going to hit Asher. So I have to make a hefty motion like this. It hits him right in the shoulder blades, right where even if he had armor, it would still get him in the neck. And it goes straight down to his nipple. and as I pull out, blood takes about 5 seconds to start leaking from that wound. But not before he crumbles to the ground and looks at me with a gaze of complete awe.
Wow.
And I think to myself, I'm good at something.
Ending lives.
And then it's not and making then I, friends.
Nope.
And then I
making
move.
Making families.
Yes.
She's great.
And then I move over to the bed right here.
Okay. Cool. Cool, cool, cool. Asher, what you doing?
I will.
It's like sing everything to us.
I will.
Come on, Mr.
Disengage.
Bard.
A
sweet serenade.
Yeah. I'm going to disengage back here.
Yeah.
Yes, a
and
thousand
I
times
will.
Yes.
Who's up next?
Atuska.
Atuska would be next.
And I'll give you an bardic inspiration.
For me?
For you.
For who? For me. For you.
I feel
for
so
you.
Spoiled now with this. And I have all kinds of fun things.
I know.
All right.
Okay.
And that's my turn.
All right. Cool, cool, cool. Atuska, it is your turn.
May I please do a short bow? Yeah, use a short bow. Yeah.
Okay.
Light.
You can, but there's nothing you can hit
you
from your angle.
Oh,
you
I
can
can't.
Move over here.
You can stand atop the corpse of the
mimic. Yeah. It is.
Oh, yeah.
It's for sure dead.
It needs to get stood on.
It's for sure dead.
You know, if you just shuffle your feet back and forth, another cat might come out.
Oh, we need one more cat.
Well, and then for Sadohas, okay. too, because we have
oh,
four.
Oh, yeah, that's
but
true.
But Sadohas doesn't need a cat.
I don't. Honestly,
no,
I don't
he doesn't need
a cat. Trust Sadohas with one.
Yeah, I guess I'll do that then. I'll stand atop the mimic and then shoot from there.
Yep.
Great. Kill that asshole. Good job.
12 and I always forget. God, was it attack?
Short bow.
There it is.
Yeah,
17.
17 hits.
Nice.
Okay, and then d6. And then eight.
Describe its death.
Really? I killed it?
You killed something. You did it, Tuska.
Good job.
So the bow goes like right through the eyes and then it circles around and goes through the other eye. And then and then the head like it like sews it together and then like squeezes it and it explodes.
It's the bow, see?
Like a bow, it's tying a bow.
So she fired her bow.
She vice grip.
It went
fire
her bow. It went flying. The arrow stayed as where it was.
Yes!
Tied vice grip and dead. I love it.
Did you see that?
I'm on board for this. Monster 2. I'm gonna
I blame you for how like gratuitously graphic that was. It's wrapped around its head and then squeezed and exploded.
Yeah.
That sounds
It
very,
all started when you shoved your sword through its nipple.
Yeah. through a kobold's nipple.
Yeah, we had a conversation about this. And we're like, kobolds don't have nipples.
Kobolds are not mammals.
I saw a nipple.
That's right.
What did Hold I see on. Then? I saw a nipple.
I have a chart here of a topless kobold. I will show it to you and there are zero nipples. There are pecs, but no nipples.
I think
is it
that
like
just
a reptile?
It is a reptile. Oh. It is an
like,
egg.
You know,
it's
just
like,
how
does
nipples.
It look like, Nathan?
No. I'll show you guys a second. I got stuff
nurse
on there.
Young to have nipples.
No, but I'm just saying, like,
why do I? I have nipples. Can I nurse you?
Look at him.
I mean,
kobolds. Oh, yeah, it's like a okay.
nipple.
If you really wanted to get down to it.
They just didn't want to make that kobold too sexy, because that's sexy looking.
It has to be PG. It's already way too sexy.
This kobold,
he's looking up in confidence.
Yeah,
exactly.
Normally, a kobold, after seeing two of his friends get killed, would run away. But because this is a backer kobold, someone who's donated to us, he is going to kill all of you. He's going to take you down Rambo style. Coming after you, Atutska, since you are...
What the heck?
You tied his friend's head in a bow.
That was
with your bow.
I was trying to make it a very nice, secure package.
It was a secure package of death.
Of death.
Oh, why? It comes at you with its dagger. Does a 10 hit your AC?
No.
Shit! Your turn.
I was like, right. Shh.
Yeah, just misses. Donovan, what are you doing?
Okay. Donovan does have space now to come in and attack that kobold.
Time to lead.
All right.
With
so,
the last.
Yeah, so Donovan comes charging in and attacks with a 17 to hit.
Let me see that. Barely hits.
Yeah.
Lies.
Okay, so Donovan rolls another 11 damage.
11 damage. Yeah. Kills it. Describe its death.
Yeah.
So Donovan comes in and chops the kobold off at the knees. And as the kobold drops, like, yep, and I finish it off, collarbone to waist.
Straight through the nipple.
So when it's the nipple.
When it splits apart, is there a cat inside?
is there a cat inside?
Where's that? No, no cat.
Hey, that's a good thing.
Number.
That means they didn't eat any cats.
Wait a minute. When you split it in half, is there half a cat inside?
Hold on. Yes.
No, he ate the cat.
I'm so sad.
Oh, don't show Barky that.
Actually, yeah, I see that half a cat, and I'm like, motherfucker, I like stomp him a little bit.
That's
jerk.
Fine, yeah.
Disrespect him in death.
Yeah, for sure disrespect him in death.
Are you guys going to take a little break, heal up?
We should definitely take
distribute the healing potions.
Yes. I'm fine.
No, we should definitely.
The fucking wizard's always
fine. I hand the purple vial that I sipped
on. I haven't raged
to,
at all.
Atuska. Do you drink it?
Well, yeah,
I definitely need a short
him.
Rest, if not
yes.
a long
yeah.
rest.
What? We have healing potions.
I know. I mean, I guess I could take a healing potion, but I don't have
to.
Any like I don't have any abilities left. But right now, I'm just like a little weak guy with a
I can heal you.
Right now.
So you're like
can
him.
Can we heal you?
Yeah.
Nice.
Can we heal you?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll heal
so
you.
So you guys are going to spend some time healing. You guys
yep.
are going to drink
well,
potions.
I don't know.
We'll figure
oh,
out
we
the map on
the
that.
rest of you guys should heal up and be all safe. I'm actually going to stand at the door, and I'm just going to open the door and look
yeah,
for
give
a naked
me,
dude.
Definitely
see if
give me
a naked dude
okay.
in the hallway.